Hello mga ka-Arki! Welcome to this special video series of Wealth Arki entitled Global Investing for the Filipino Investor, which is done in partnership with AXA Philippines. Kasama natin dito sa video series na to si Mr. Dexter Agkawili, who is the Investment Solutions Director of AXA Philippines and the country representative to Arkitas Asia, an asset management company of the AXA Group. Check out the video description for the links to all the 5 episodes of this video series. That's it for my intro. Let's begin. Hello mga ka-Arki, kamusta kayo? And welcome dito sa episode 5 and the final episode dito sa ating special video series na pinagmagatan nating Global Investing for the Filipino Investor. Yeah, so kamusta Dexter? Kamusta Renzi?
Okay naman ito. Very very much piqued ang aking interest sa global investing, most especially when I've known yung mga roster na meron ang AXA as regards global investing. Well, may mga kliyente din naman ako na in-advise for global investing, pero kapag ganito kasing may mga bagong products sa market, na-excite ako. I'm so excited and I just can't hide it. Ang daming choice kasi eh, di ba? Where one fund manager can have some exposure, hindi naman nila makakover. Some others can complement it as well. But yeah, I'm very happy.
Oh, ako naman, right. Renzi and Fitz, this is really close to my heart dahil I've been through a lot of markets and mula nung I started in the industry. I was already doing global investing for the institution. Pero isa sa mga talagang challenging part is that if I want to do it on my own, yun yung mahirap na eh. Diba? Hindi mo ma-access yung mga markets na yan. And through time nakita ko how our industry has changed and how different institutions have made it possible for the common Filipino to invest globally.
Mm-hmm. So throughout this video series, starting from episode 1, nakita natin na dati mahirap mag-invest globally, pero ngayon mas madali na dahil may mga financial institutions like AXA who offer the opportunities, the convenience, and the access sa atin. And we've also discussed sa previous episode natin yung mga benefits and advantages of investing in the global markets. We've also taught you yung mga strategies and the proper ways to choose the right investment for you depending on your risk profile, on your financial goal, your investment horizon, etc. And today for our final episode, we will be telling you mga iba't ibang paraan kung paano mag-invest globally. So particularly, siyempre, ang unang option is doing it yourself. You can invest directly sa global markets by opening an account offshore sa mga foreign platforms or mga foreign brokers. And the second option is doing it locally through financial institutions such as AXA Philippines and accessing the global markets through mga funds, no, mga investment funds. At yan yung pag-uusapan natin today. So, as a starter question, pwedeng either of you can start. Ano ba yung mga different ways to invest in the global market? Ano ba yung mga, siguro let's start with yung mga direct investing and then move towards yung other options through financial partners.
So, here in the Philippines, if you want to open an equities account, okay, you can do that through a stock broker. Opening a fixed income account, you can do that through, let's say, a bank or through a bank usually. Now, pero pag opening ka na ng global equities account, medyo hindi ganun kadali eh, di ba? Dahil, one, may mga tanong about your residency, tapos yung mga KYC kung tawagin, or knowing your customer. So it's one of the things that I would I actually experienced through time, and I realized that it's not that easy if you want go to do direct. But now it's relatively easy naman if you're doing direct investing here in the local market, dahil nag-open ka naman ng, with an account with a financial institution na kahit paano mas kilala ka. Mm-hmm. Yun.
And apart from that, Dex, no, I mean, you know, global equity store, right? But if, for example, medyo you're on the conservative side, or sabihin na lang natin na medyo nearing towards retirement ka na, for you to access global fixed income, I think mas mahirap ata mag-access ng global fixed income sa global equities, right? Parang I don't know of how, if you even have platforms for ano, for you to access global fixed income as well.
Actually, diba? On the global fixed income, isang magandang point yan, Renzi, dahil kahit locally, kung bibili ka ng RTB, ayun, okay, kung RTB, kung open ka ng account sa banko. Pero kapag corporate bonds, kinakailangan minimum of 50 or 100,000 pesos, yeah. Diba? Depende sa ano, sa issue size ng ano, nung corporate na yon, no?
Yeah,
so,
and on top of
challenges.
That, yes, and then on top of that as well, I would imagine, no, kunari, I want exposure to China, fixed income, right? Kasi, kunari, feeling ko maganda yung fixed income environment ng China. Siguro, para makapag-open ako, may papansin kaya sa akin na mag-open ng 50,000
pesos.
Or 5,000 pesos, di ba? And bukod pa doon, di ba, bukod pa doon, I mean, anong platform ako makakapag-open ng China, for a China bond, right? So, for the ordinary retail investor, medyo mahirap din, no? Kung gusto nila ng exposure with global fixed income. And I would imagine also, Dexter, no? Siyempre, kung mag-invest ka ng mga, kunari, marami, samut-sari, na global equity with different regions, you know, as many brokers would you deal with, would be as many account opening forms and as many, di ba? Ang dami mong sasagutan, right?
Yeah. Kasi bawat market, dapat meron kang ma-open na account eh. Para doon ka makabili ka through that particular broker.
So imagine kung
isang challenge mo, paglipat mo mula, kunyari, kung yung pera mo nasa Philippines, nililipat mo ngayon papunta sa Singapore, at tapos ililipat mo sa US, yung paglipat ng pera mo para makabili ka, it's another challenge.
Di ba usually ang settlement pag mga global funds, mga 5 days yan, di ba? 5 to 7 days, right? So, you know, parang it's it's an administrative nightmare.
Nightmare.
Diba? Logistical pa rin na lipat ng funds, open, ang dami-daming broker, international pa. Apart from that one as well, no? Yung minimum amount to invest as well, diba? Mm-hmm. Hindi ka naman, I mean, we're talking of global markets, diba? So, sana yan sa mga malalaking accounts, malalaking institution, mga high net worth individual na, you know, if you're ordinary retail investor, then baka hindi, you cannot get that, you know, that global footprint as easily.
Yes, magandang ilagay nga sa context, no? Kung titignan natin lahat ng mga financial institutions here in the Philippines, ilan ba dyan yung nakaka-offer ng global UITF or global mutual fund? Hindi lahat, di ba?
That's right.
Mga companies na to, they would have to go through that process of opening accounts to be directly invested, and then kikreate sila ng fund for the customer. But not everybody could offer. Gives you an idea na kung ganun kahirap for financial institutions to actually do it, not everybody's doing it, what more pa kung sa common retail investor like us.
Right. And right now, maganda, nabanggit nga ni Dex, no, na there are institutions, no, like banks, like insurance companies, like AXA, even some asset management companies are already offering this particular access to the global markets through their different product offers. So yun nga, nabanggit ni Fitz, parang matunog ngayon mga platform, di ba? Ganyan, iba-ibang platform. Yeah. Diba? You can have those na, you know, you can buy diretso, kunwari, you want a tech flavor, you can buy diretso Facebook, buy diretso Google or Alphabet, buy diretso, Samsung as well. Pero yun na nga, yung mga companies na to, financial institutions right now are already offering their products mainly through ano, no, through their funds, di ba? Mainly through their funds. So kumbaga sila yung nagsaset up, and then sila na mismo yung ano ba, either sila na mismo yung namimili ng securities or ng stocks or ng bonds na laman, tapos kumbaga makikiride ka na lang, or in the case of ano, in the case of AXA, iba-iba, you have, I saw, no, may funds kayo na diretsong nag-i-invest sa mga stocks or sa mga bonds, pero meron din kayo mga funds na fund of funds. Oh. Kasi iba-iba. Siguro,
isa-isahin natin yan.
Isa-isahin natin. Yeah. So, you have direct, di ba? You have direct trading. Have direct. So, diretsong bili, di ba? Then, may tinatawag ka ng mga ETF. Ano yung mga ETF na yan?
So, ang usual exchange-traded funds, yung ibig sabihin ng ETF, di ba? And napaka-close to stocks where a stock of a company is trading in an exchange. In this, in an ETF naman, yung fund, in parang mutual fund yan eh. Ang difference lang ng mutual fund with an ETF is that yung stocks ng mutual fund, kailangan pumunta ka directly dun sa mutual fund company para makabili ng stocks niya. Kaya in an ETF, you can buy the stocks of that fund through the exchange, parang katulad ng bumili ka through your online trading account, similar to that. So ang usually kapag ETF, or exchange-traded funds, ito yung mga, kung tawagin natin, mga index-tracking ETFs. Itong pinaka-common na ETF dahil pag binili mo ang isang ETF, nai-invest na siya sa isang index or equity index. Kaya siya pinaka-common dahil pinakamadali is that pag binili ni customer yung ETF, alam niya na parang invested siya doon sa index na yon. Mas madaling ano, mas madaling maunawaan, kaya siya mas common. Ngayon, kapag yung that's one ETF at saka mutual fund, right? Very similar ang difference ng paano siya i-access. Okay. Tapos another kind of fund that is really common now with financial institutions is what we would call yung feeder fund. Na.
Ano naman yung feeder fund na yan? Dumadami eh.
Oo, di ba? So, para sa ano, sa benefit ng retail investor, a financial institution will create a fund. Now, yung fund na to, ang meron siyang bibilin or ang tawag sa kanya is a feeder fund. Bibili siya dun sa isang fund na naka-invest globally, na target fund kung tawagin natin. So, the whole point is that one fund will be investing into this globally diversified na fund na kumbaga ang hawak niya lang is yung security or yung units nitong fund na to or stocks ng funds or shares ng stock ng fund na to.
So kumbaga Dex, parang ano to, no, parang isang meron kang global fund, tapos yung local fund is naka-invest doon. So isang yung fund ang laman, isang fund lang din.
Yes, yes.
Ah, okay, that's a feeder fund, which is the target fund. Okay.
So that's, well, that's another form of investing globally, di ba? And meron naman tayong tinatawag rin na fund of funds.
parang inception to ha? May mutual fund, may ETF, may feeder fund, meron naman ng fund of funds. Ano naman to? Fund of funds.
Okay.
Fund of funds. Ang pinaka, more funds in the Philippines, ha.
Ang pinaka simple way of talking about this is that, 'di ba? For example, tayo, meron ako, for example, meron akong investment sa isang bank, ABC Bank, yung equity fund nila. Dahil gusto ko, dahil magaling sila mag-track ng index. Okay, kaya binili ko yung index fund niya. Tapos, bumili rin ako dito sa ano, CDG fund ng isang bank. Dahil magaling to pag stock picking. Actively managed na equity fund. Tapos bumili ako ng isa pa dahil maganda yung high dividend fund nitong isang bank na to. Okay. So, kung titingnan ko yung portfolio ko, meron akong tatlong equity funds. Pero lahat yun in equities, diba? Now, pinili ko sila dahil one, isa magaling mag-track ng index, isa talagang magaling mag-generate ng alpha, yung isa high dividend strategy. Pero punto ko is na-diversify ko into those three different funds. And kung titignan mo yung ngayon yung fund ko, or yung portfolio ko, meron na akong tatlong funds. Yan. So, simplistically looking at it, ganun ang fund of funds. One fund is invested into different funds, into different kinds of asset managers na pwedeng magaling yung isa sa pag-follow ng index, magaling yung isa pag sa high dividend type of strategy, yung isa naman magaling siya in generating alpha talaga. So, yun yung one reason why there's such a thing as fund of funds, and one good reason why there should be such a fund of funds, dahil tutulungan niya na tayo na i-diversify into different kinds of asset managers in a particular asset class, or sa konteksto ng global funds, into different parts of the world na.
So kumbaga no, yung mga mutual funds are nag-iinvest diretso sa mga stocks or bonds. Yung mga feeder fund naman, it is a fund na nag-iinvest sa isang fund. So isang fund lang ang laman. Ang fund of funds, isang fund, ang laman maraming funds.
Yes.
Pagdating sa directly investing in global markets, kung nasa Pilipinas ka, syempre you need to open an account with a foreign broker. But first of all, you would have to decide kung saang market ka mag-invest or mag-trade. So kung gusto mo ng US market, make sure na yung broker na mag-open ka ng account ay nag-o-offer ng mga US companies. And as mentioned earlier, kung gusto mo talaga mag-invest globally, it might require you to open several accounts from different brokers, which adds to the challenge na yung fund mo, kailangan mo ng malaking pera para makapag-invest sa iba't ibang mga markets. Ngayon, pagdating sa foreign brokers, hindi rin siya ganun ka simple na you can open an account and then you can already buy stocks or US stocks, for example. Kasi you would have to check with the broker kung are they offering the underlying asset, or baka mamaya CFD lang yung ino-offer nila. So yung contracts for difference, yun yung nag-a-allow for a person to invest a small amount. For example, $200 lang yung initial deposit. So that's good na maliit lang. However, yung mga foreign brokers na usually maliit yung minimum investment, CFD yung ino-offer. Kasi kung talagang gusto mong bilhin yung underlying asset niya, then usually they require a higher minimum amount to open an account.
Open, yeah.
Ang naging development lang niya in recent years is yung application or opening an account, it became easier, but the access is still a challenge. Ibig sabihin, kung gusto kong mag-trade or mag-invest sa European market, baka iba yung broker para sa US market if I want to trade yung Singaporean or Southeast Asian market. So, ang ending yan, I would end up with 4 or 5 different foreign brokers. May mga foreign brokers din na yes, they offer companies in the US stock market, for example, pero select lang. Minsan yung mga blue chip companies lang yung mabibili mo ron. So kung may opportunity, may volatility sa isang company na hindi popular, hindi ka makaka-trade noon kasi hindi siya ino-offer dun sa platform. So maraming consideration. And I would say, unfortunately, in the past several years, wala masyadong improvement yung access and availability ng investing directly sa mga different types of markets and different types of assets. Kaya para sa akin, napakagandang news nung yung a lot of local financial institutions kasama ang AXA is now starting to offer yung feeder funds, fund of funds, and other global funds.
Siguro dagdag ko din dun yung yung time difference.
Paano yung trade mo?
Oh, isipin mo, kunwari, oh, nasa local stock market ka, so during the day, di ba, technical-technical ka, whatever, MACD, RSI, whatever you have there. Tapos, tipong paggabi, magte-trade ka na naman for your, ano, for your offshore market, di ba? So, ano yun? Sumalangit naman, di ba yun? Parang walang tulugan, kuya germ sila. So, hindi ka na matutulog, right? So, yun din ang, I think for me, no? So, napag-usapan na naman natin yung different ways, no? Kapag nag-direct ka, yun, barriers to entry, and then, yun nga, yung time din talaga. Imbis na natutulog ka, eh, nagte-trade ka pa, di ba? Saka, iba rin eh, di ba? I mean, local stock market, hindi mo na siya, I mean, nobody can really predict the local stock market, no, with all of its, I don't know, different variables and factors. Tapos, lalabas ka pa sa global market. Yeah. Di ba, na hindi mo kabisado yung market? Oh, paano mo makakover yun, di ba? Paano mo pag-aaralan yun? Eh, dito na nga sa local, nahihirapan ka na mag-global ka pa. Wala ka pa dun sa bansa na yun.
Yeah, pero Renzi, ano, may mga tao na mas gusto nila yung control kasi yun naman yung ano advantage no meron kang ano self-determination kung saan ilalagay yung pera mo but of course that requires skills and knowledge and resources to do so I guess ang next na tanong ko is ano ba yung magandang strategy meaning how do you determine which strategy is best suited for you. Kasi may mga kilala talaga ako na gusto talaga nila na direct sila, direct. Na nag-invest. And they're making money na somehow na-manage nila yung time and resources sila to get good returns. But of course, may mga kilala ako na medyo busy din sa pagninegosyo or busy sa
parang
trabaho,
ako.
Career.
Parang ako.
So, walang time. So yes, I would say na para sa'yo, Renzi, best suited sa'yo yung mag-invest locally sa mga global funds. But in general, ano ba yung mga factors na kailangan tinitingnan ng isang tao to determine which strategy would best suit them?
Yeah. Good point kanina, Fitz, when you mentioned about certain people having a certain preference na going direct. And there are really those na particularly in my experience, I did have mga high net worth customers na sophisticated din. Akalain mo mayroong sariling Bloomberg sa loob ng ano, sa loob
talaga?
Ng kanya.
Oy, oh, paano Bloomberg ah?
Sa office pero mismo niya, 'di ba? Oh. So, kumbaga, may mga ganong klaseng ano, tao na mayaman sila, may oras sila, kaya kumbaga gusto lang nilang mag-enjoy at matuto talaga ng mag-trade. May mga ganon. Now, pero ang interesting thing about such profiles of customers is that hindi naman talaga lahat ng investments nila sila nagba-manage. Kasi in the end, minsan talagang it's a matter of them addressing that certain itch na gusto ko yung and proving that they did right. So, and looking at these kinds of types of sophisticated investors, they still see the value of also having a diversified portfolio. So, usually meron silang ina-allocate na sila mismo magde-direct yan, may control sila over it. And then meron silang mga chinu-choose na, gusto ko lang index funds para kahit paano, controlled pa rin niya yung global allocation niya. Allocation sa Europe, allocation sa US. And then, may mga conviction trades na lang siya on particular sectors, on certain ano issues or certain stocks. May mga ganong strategy. And nakikita ko din yan sa mga certain customers na meron silang mix of funds and also yung mga direct. Now, to the point that I'm driving at is degree of expertise is very important. If you know, if you're really an expert on that, sure, you can have that. But for what I have experienced, even experts would delegate that control to an extent through a diversified portfolio, such as an asset manager, or through directly investing into funds of these asset managers. So these are mga possible things. And I think for the more retail, like such as ourselves, doon naman magiging important yung we get to have that economies of scale, meaning in terms of ilan yung pera ko, pero madadiversify ko na siya in different regions instead of trying to put up like millions muna para lang maka-open ng account, di ba? So, we get to take advantage of such a scale through funds. So, it's a key consideration then. Yung time na na-mention ni Renzi, do you have the time? Yan lang ba yung gagawin mo all day in, day out? Di ba? But if you are someone na tipong meron ka talagang full-time work or full you are a professional doing something else, you can delegate it through expert fund managers by being invested into such diversified funds.
Yeah. So Dexter, may tanong ako. Pag sinabi bang isang global fund, isang tao lang ba yung nagmamanage yan, yung fund manager lang ba? Or merong bang team yan or merong board of directors, I would say? Paano ba usually hinahandle ng isang asset management company yung isang fund nila?
Okay. So, lalo na kapag mga global funds, there are similar to how, let's say, a local asset manager operates, merong mga analysts in different sectors and also different geographic locations. And then, merong mga fund managers who then look into ano yung mga researches nitong analyst na to para they could select the right fund to invest in on a particular geographic location. So, there's merong kumbaga may proseso silang ginagawa and hindi lang yan decision ng isang tao, kumbaga merong mga different levels from analyst, pinifilter ko ano yung mga kinakailangang mga nagka-qualify dun sa kanilang parameters, and then the fund manager who then decides, okay, out of what was recommended, and then I get to invest into different types of assets or different funds of fund managers. So merong mga professionals looking into that, and meron silang mga kanya-kanya mga responsibilities. Minsan nga may mga asset managers pa na talaga tinitignan niya lang yung allocation, and then merong talagang asset managers naman na merong kumbaga asset allocator yung una, tapos merong talagang kung ano yung inallocate mo sa particular asset class, ay ito siya na ngayon yung magseselect kung ano yung mga funds or mga investments na for that particular asset class.
So for example, ang call ko, kunwari, yung balance fund natin, mukhang medyo gumaganda yung global market, so siguro pwede tayong from 40%, 45% equity, pwede mag 55% muna tayo, di ba? Tapos meron kang tao na mag-handle lang, ako na bahala dito sa 55% kung paano ko hahatiin to. May ganun pa din.
Yes, yes. Okay. Tapos meron din dyan yung mga governance kung tawagin. Kumbaga, tinitingnan kung, kasi bawat fund meron mga limits din yan. In-implement. To ensure na hindi magiging too risky dun sa mandato or mandate of that fund. So, meron din mga grupo na tumitingin ng, okay, nagbe-breach ka ba ng limit or na may maintain ba kung mga
compliance? Sumasobra ba?
Sumasobra.
Okay. Galing.
So, kung ako ay mag-i-invest sa isang, sabihin na natin, global fund, hindi ibig sabihin na yung pera ko ay pupunta lang sa isang tao tapos siya na yung bahala, no? There's really a team na nag-uusap na may kanya-kanyang responsibility who are working together to maximize the returns ng fund and to maximize the returns of my investment. Which means, siguro, isa sa mga kailangan din malaman is how do you choose ngayon yung tamang fund? Kasi, syempre, maraming funds available, especially yung mga global funds din, no? Unti-unting dumadami rin yung available sa akin. So, how do you choose the right fund with respect dun sa fund manager or fund asset management na ino-offer na service? So, what are the factors that you need to consider?
Well, unang-una dyan yung reputation. Diba? Mm-hmm. Reputation ng institution that you're dealing with. Dahil, in the end, kung tayo yung investor, pinagkakatiwala natin yung pera natin eh, di ba? Dun sa pag-investan mong fund. So, the reputation of that fund manager is one. And then,
sino ba yan, di ba? Sino ba yung fund manager na yan? Kumbaga, kunwari, nag-foreign broker tayo eh, ewan ko lang, basic sa akin, dapat may opisina ba yan? Di ba? May opisina ba yan? Saan ba opisina yan? Saan ba address niyan? Right? Saka yung bukod sa reputation, yun nga, I think we'll touch on that later. Pero yeah, the reputation. Sino, who are you dealing with? Di ba? Who are you dealing with? Your hard-earned money.
Yes. And then, next is performance and track record. Then, I'd like to highlight two key items here. Dahil minsan, mayroong mga tipong fund manager na kilala mo yung particular person, di ba? Pero when we talk of fund manager, we're not just talking of a person but rather the institution. Okay.
Yes.
Dahil ang risk na tipong, uy, kilala ko tong taong tong fund manager na to na employed ni ABC company ngayon. Paano kapag tipong lumipat na yon? Dala-dala ba ng taong yun yung expertise or are you investing dun sa expertise nung institution?
That's right.
It's a very good question that we should always ask. Diba? Na pag tinignan natin yung performance at saka track record, hindi lang yung particular person na yun na nagmamanage ng isang fund or dalawa or tatlong funds nung particular institution, but rather the track record of that institution. Dahil dapat unawain natin na ang investment proseso to. So, ano ba yung institusyon na ilagay na nila yung proseso nila in place na kahit sinong i-hire nila na tao na mag-manage ng mga tao nag-manage ng funds na yun, is tatakbo na mainam yan at in a very good way. Kahit that's umalis yung mga tao yun, ma-replacean, the process is there. The investment process is robust.
Magandang parameter yung performance and track record, pero it doesn't mean na dun ka lagi sa number one kasi
isa rin naman
yun. That's also a common mistake that I see kasi ni number one dun sila mag-i-invest, pero if you look at yung mga past years, makikita mo may mga companies na laging nasa top 5 or nasa alam mo yun, top quarter. And I think that's a better way to determine kung ano yung mga pwede mong investan na mga funds. So bukod sa reputation, right, performance, and track record, ano pa ba, Dexter? I think yung network and resources nung company, yes, no? That also important.
Yes. Kasi may important kung gaano ka lalim ba yung bench, kumbaga, nung ano. One is lalim ng bench nung fund manager, meaning gaano kalaki ba yung investment team niya, and then meron bang sariling research team ba yan, meron bang how many are there? Dahil parang knowing a company, di ba, gusto mo malaman kung sino-sino yung mga nandyan, yung proper structure nila, nandyan, is it in place yun. And ang part of it, so that network also and the resources that we would call, yung say is that asset manager just really in one location or also well entrenched in different parts of the world. That's another key consideration,
which is very important when you talk of global investing. Eh, syempre, kung global investing, ang gusto ko naman yung nagde-decide dyan, nando doon on the spot kung nasa ng gera, di ba? Where the investments are.
Kumbaga, may footprint ba sila doon sa mga countries na ininvestan nila? That's another consideration.
I hope yung mga ka-Arki natin ay maraming natutunan tungkol sa mga iba't ibang paraan kung paano mag-invest globally. And particularly, if they're interested to learn more about the global funds that AXA is offering, including yung mga points na ni-raise natin na if they want to see how the global funds of AXA stacks up against other funds pagdating sa kanyang performance and track record, then they can definitely contact an AXA financial partner, an AXA financial advisor by simply going to their website at axa.com.ph/appointments. And of course, ayan, lagi natin pinapakita yung ating QR code. So, pwede din tayo mag-set ng appointment by scanning the QR code and filling out the form that will appear on your browser. So, I guess, with that, I would like to conclude itong ating special video series. I hope maraming natutunan yung ating mga ka-Arki pagdating sa global investing. And maraming salamat sa iyo, Dexter, for joining us in the past
five
episodes.
Thank you.
Any parting words, Dexter, sa mga ka-Arki natin na nag-iisip kung saan ba magsisimula pagdating sa pag-invest?
Yes.
Globally, no? So, ano na sila, umay na sila sa Philippine economy.
Yeah. O kaya, ano, kasi, or tipong nabobore na sa Philippines, sa local, no? Nabobore na, walang movement.
Oh, hindi man ako kumikita dito sa Philippine investments. So, itry natin yung global investment. So, ano bang mga tips na pwede mong ibigay sa kanila?
Okay. So, well, for one, again, as we explore investing beyond our shores, it's important that we get to really look at the kinds of asset managers or fund managers that we are investing in. So always look at who these are. So knowing these fund managers as reputable and well-established institutions is somehow a good way to start it para may peace of mind ka. And best that when you do, always make sure that you have a plan or your investment plan. We went through the hero's approach that I shared to you in coming up with a plan, and that is the start for you to come up with a portfolio that is appropriate to your risk profile. And that is very important para you can weather the movement of the market up and down in the long run. You get to really stay invested. Lastly, I'd like to really encourage everyone to invest beyond the Philippine shores. It is an opportunity for us to have a globally diversified portfolio. And this will help us in reaching our financial goals. Okay? So create that globally diversified portfolio. Have that global investing game plan. And only work with a reputable financial institution.
So maraming salamat mga ka-Arki dito sa panonood sa ating special video series on global investing for the Filipino investor. So please remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to learn more about personal finance, business, and investments. And of course, in behalf of Renzi and Dexter, I would like to say goodbye. I hope you all take care and stay safe. All right, bye-bye!
Bye-bye! Thanks, Dex!
Mga ka-Arki, as we learned, global investing may just be the key to reaching your financial goals. But remember to study your options first and work with a trusted financial institution. Reach out to an AXA financial partner today, and we will help you create your global investing game plan.